Hello folks, welcome back. In this video, I will demo on how to call a flow from PowerApps to send email. So stay tuned and let's go to the demo after this short intro. Now let's look at the requirement first. So the idea is that we need to create a new PowerApps application with a form containing customer contact detail. For example, customer name, email address, phone number, etc. and a button to submit that information. Once the button is clicked, the information entered by the user on the PowerApps form needs to be emailed to the manager. To achieve this, I will first create a blank canvas app in PowerApps. I will create a form containing all the fields and a button. Then I will create an automated flow in Power Automate, and I will use the PowerApps as a trigger option in the flow. I will configure the flow to get PowerApps form data and email to manager. Finally, I will link the PowerApps form to the newly created Power Automate flow on button click. So let's start the demo. I am on Office 365 landing page. From the left menu, you can see these ellipses. If I click on them, you can see all the application listed here. If you don't see the PowerApp application here, you can click on all apps. And then if I scroll down, you should be able to see the PowerApp application here. So it's listed here. So if I click on it, that will take me to the PowerApps landing page where I can create the PowerApp application. So as I said before, we're gonna create a canvas app from blank. So I will click on canvas app from blank option, and I will give this app a name. I will just call it client contacts, and by default I will leave it as a tablet app. We'll click on create button here. This will create a blank canvas app for me where I can drag and drop the fields and create my first form. So this is an empty area to work with. If I go from the top menu under the insert tab, and if I check the label first and I get my first label, so this will be the name, and then I put another label here. This may be email address, and that's it. I will just create two label here. Then I will create a text field from here, text input field, so the person can input the name and email of the client. So the first one will be here. So I can rename this text input one, name txt. And then I will create another one, text input as well. And this one I will rename it to the email txt. Now I need a button. So if I click on the button icon here, this will create a button for me. I will change the text of the button from this right hand property menu. Just call it submit. Now the form is pretty much done. So we want to capture the person name and email address. Now what we actually want is if someone click this button, it should actually email that information to the manager. So we need to create a Power Automate flow which will actually collect this information from Power Apps and email to the manager. So if I navigate back to Office 365, from the left menu I will select the option of Power Automate. By the way, you can come on this action menu inside the Power App and click Power Automate, and you can create a flow from here as well. But I will show you from the Power Automate application icon how you can create a flow and then later on attach that flow to this app. So you may already have a flow which you want to use in the Power Automate, so you can do that way. If I go back to Power Automate, I will click on create. So I will create an instant cloud flow because this is going to be a trigger by this Power App. So I cannot use an automated flow. I need to use an instant cloud flow option. So if I click on that, I will give this flow a name. Say send client information, and the trigger for this flow is going to be Power Apps. Use a button or link in Power Apps to trigger an action in this flow. So I will select that and I will click on create. Now the trigger is created. So next step is we need to send an email to the manager. So if I click on next step, I will just say send an email notification. Just for this testing, I will just put my name in there. So I will select my name and I will say in the title, I'll just say new client, and then in the body of the email, I will just put the body ask in Power Apps. So if I select that, so whatever we send from Power App is going to be in the body. So if I go back to Power App, we have a name input and email input. So we'll capture these both fields and then we will send it to the body of this email. So if I click on save, so the name of the workflow is send client information. So that information is saved. So the Power Automate is saved. We have created a Power Automate flow for Power App. So now if I go back to client contacts, now I will select this submit button. and I will click on Power Automate and I will click on Send Client Information. Now this is connecting the Power Automate flow with this Power App. So Send Client Information dot run. So in here, inside this dot run method, we need to provide the body what we're going to send. So the body, we can make something like, we can either put in a variable, or we can just put the name and the email value inside the body as it is. So let's create a variable. So before this, we will just create a set. We'll create a variable. We'll call it HTML string. And let me just close this one for now. So we have a separate method there. So HTML string, and the value we're going to set to this HTML string. So we need to set the HTML string value. So we need to get the name and the email. But to do in a better way, what we'll do is we will create the name and email labels as well, and then the values. So to make the label bold, I will just use B, and then I will say name colon space, and then I will use and the value of that column, which is from name text dot text. So we'll say name text dot text, yeah, and then I will do and then again I will do break line, so break row br in HTML, and then also do bold again, and this time inside that bold I will do the email. Just put email colon space, and then at the end I will do and again, now the value from this email text column. So email txt dot text. So now we have that HTML string variable which contains the name label in bold and the value and the email in bold after break row and the value in the email column. Now we can pass this HTML string variable to this method which is running the flow, so it can have that variable in the body. So we are passing that variable here to the Power Automate flow method. So now when we'll run this application, when we fill the information and submit, this label will collect the information and it will pass it on to the flow, and then flow is already putting that information in the body of the email. So I will click on file and click on save, and the name is client contact, which is fine, saving in the cloud. Now the Power App is saved. If I click on share, I can share with other people, or I can just click on the web link to access the app. The workflow, we have already saved it and it's ready to use. So if I go one step back, I will see the run history of the workflow when it has run successfully. Okay, now if I navigate to the app, and I will put the name here, put name as Neil Gibson. I will just put email address as neil@outlook.com, and I will click on submit. You can make this form fancy, you can add more fields, you can make it navigate to a submit or success screen. So now if I go to manage my flow, and if I refresh this page, this flow should have already ran. So now you can see the flow already ran successfully, and it has managed to send an email. And now you can see the body of the email is something like this. Now if I navigate back to my Outlook, there is an email received, and you can see the name and email are in bold as we said in the HTML code. And this information is coming from the Power Apps application using Power Automate into your email inbox. Just to wrap up today's video, today you have learned how to call a Microsoft Power Automate flow from Power Apps application on a click of a button. Thank you for watching this video. Consider subscribing if you're new to the channel by pressing the red subscribe button below this video and click the notification bell icon so you don't miss any of my future videos as I upload new videos every week. Give this video a thumbs up if you found it useful. If you have any questions regarding this topic or any other query related to Office 365, please put in the comment section below. I do review my comments on a daily basis, so I will be happy to answer your questions. Thank you.